Hey, yo, and what's up, tribe? Let's be a blockhead for a second. Let's talk about time blocking. So we've got your mission down, we've got your routines down, your focus is coming together. How can we get you more opportunity for focus in our life? If you're the type of person who often gets distracted, if you're the type of person who thinks multitasking is a good thing, this video is for you. So in this video, essentially what I'm talking to you about is defending your time, telling people, no, this is a time for me to do something else, telling yourself that you are dedicating your time to a specific task, whether that task is work-related or whether that task is something for yourself, your friends, or your family. We're talking about time blocking. Time blocking is a technique where you're defending your time from people and things that would steal it. Look, tribe, your time is valuable. You should value your time just as much as you value money. What is your desired hourly? That is how much your time is worth. If you start seeing that every hour that you're not productive as you should be, when you should be, you're actually wasting that money. So imagine that you only really waste 30 minutes a day, a couple seconds here, a couple seconds there, maybe a minute, time to get yourself ramped up. Well, that in 5 days is 2.5 hours per week. Times 50 weeks is 125 hours. 125 hours times a smaller consulting fee of $100 an hour, that's more than $12,000. This is especially important if you are working for yourself. Be deliberate when you're working, and equally important, be deliberate when you're not. Let me say that in my humblest of opinion and somewhat expertise, when we think about a lot of the students that I've seen in my life, people cannot multitask. Computers don't even multitask. A single processor computer, if we want to simplify this, really only handles one instruction at a time. It just flips through them fast. Now, a computer doesn't need to warm up, but our brains often do. So if you're trying to balance out two different tasks, well, your mind has to change those mindsets. So by and large, with one major exception, I suggest you avoid any type of multitasking. So when it comes to this time blocking technique, you want to think about designating a specific time to do specific things. You might designate 6 o'clock in the morning to 8 o'clock in the morning as a workout time. That means you work out. You don't text, you don't surf the internet, or anything else that can take your mind away from focusing on that workout. Now, when you're doing a task, you may eventually find yourself in that productivity zone or something similar where you're focused. So in other words, if you're in an email zone, you're focused on the email, you're banging out those emails, you're in communication mode, you're hot, you're replying to things without having to think about it. If you're in a workout mode, you're focusing on your form, you're watching the time, you're making sure that you're getting your sets down, you're not straining or grunting. If you're running or you're on a treadmill, you're not going to trip and fall off the treadmill. It's great. Also equally important, when you're with your friends, when you're with your family, when you're with your loved ones, you can stay focused on them if you adhere to this time blocking technique. Now, I did say that there are some times when I multitask. If I've got one dominant and one passive thing that I happen to be doing, then I will combine, overlap, and work on two things. A great example of this is when I go to the gym. The first machine I hop on is a recumbent bike. I don't have to think about anything. I'm there to warm my legs up, get my heart rate going. That's easy. All I have to do is start spinning for about 10, 15 minutes. And to multitask, I might hit the news, but actually that's the time that I use to work on some of my Spanish lessons. It's a great opportunity for me to get two things done at once. And it's almost like multiplying my time, but only specifically for that thing. Once I get into something that needs more of my attention, when I'm on the elliptical or when I'm running, the phone gets away. And that way, I'm making sure that I'm moving properly. I'm not going to cause myself any injuries because I'm not paying attention to my form. These things are important to me. I mentioned email, and email is probably the most important thing that I time block, and I recommend it for a lot of people. Now, it's tricky. A lot of people have come to expect almost immediate replies to emails when you send them, and that requires you to manage those expectations. I'm working to get to the point where I'm only checking email in the morning. If someone wants something super important from me, they can call me, they can text me, they can use any one of the messaging services out there. Heck, if it happens to be a professional contact, they can even message me on LinkedIn and I'll get that if it's important. If it's students, students have a 24-hour window. Students are not supposed to expect 24-hour turnaround time. So they are supposed to manage themselves and their projects and their exams accordingly. So what do I do? Well, first of all, there's no email notifications on my phone ever. I can check it. I have to go through a couple extra steps to check it on my phone if I absolutely need to. I do recognize that once in a while, a conversation is really important. However, what really matters is what I do on the computer. I go and I quit that email program when I'm done with that particular email time. I don't have any dings, blings, quacks, or any of the other distractions that are going to pull my attention from a document that I might be working on, from something I might be grading, or anything like that. It is not going to take my attention away from there. Those notifications, even when they pop up, you know, even the minor ones that are junk mail, yeah, they still pull your attention away from what you're reading, but sometimes you may even see a subject matter that you're tempted to move to, tempted to read, and you don't want that to get your attention. Super important though, that if you're not checking it very frequently, you may want to put something in your signature file just to say, hey, this is when I check email. If you're messaging me for something that's more important, please give me a phone call so I can give it my attention. Just as important as that is blocking your personal time and defending that personal time. Don't let people take time away from your family and your friends and your loved ones. They're there to make sure that you're sane, after all. They're there to make sure that you're having fun. You're not, we don't want you working all the time. There is that toxic productivity of work, 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 work. Don't do that. Make sure that you're spending time with your friends or your recreation or your gym completely away from things that actually can cause you stress. And try, I can tell you right now, I love everything that I do. I love my students. I love teaching, but I also know that to continue to love it, it requires me to take a break from it every now and then, because even something that you love can cause you stress. And on a final note, there are a lot of people that use to-do lists. You'll find that most people who are super uber productive have moved from to-do list and choose to do time blocking instead. To-do lists are great if you're trying to just catalog what you need to do, but what I'm telling you is that most people have found time blocking to be a far more effective way of being productive and managing your time. Okay, tribe. Hey, that's time blocking. It is not complex. It is very simple. It's something that you can start doing. All you have to do is put it into your calendar, make sure you adhere to it, put it into your routine, just like I talked about in that last video, and you are going to be set to being so much more productive. You're going to be so much less stressed when you find that you're achieving more results, you're getting more done, and it's getting done with higher quality because you are super focused. Okay, tribe. Hey, thanks for tuning into this video. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to ring that bell, and I will see you next week. In the meantime, I hope you're a little bit better today than you were yesterday, and I'm looking forward to you being a little bit better tomorrow than you were today. Take care.